Welcome to Optical Fiber Communication playlist. Here in this session, I'll be going to explain acceptance angle and numerical aperture. And in this session, I'll explain derivation of acceptance angle and numerical aperture with a calculation which will be helpful to you to understand examples based on acceptance angle and numerical aperture. So let us begin this session with, first of all, what is the basic meaning of acceptance angle and numerical aperture. Now see, acceptance angle, it is the maximum angle to the fiber axis at which light ray may enter the fiber axis in order to get propagated. And numerical aperture, that has been used to describe the light gathering or light collecting ability of optical fiber. Now let us try to understand this with optical fiber so it will be more clear. Now see, if I consider this fiber, where this is core and this is cladding. Core is having refractive index N1 and cladding, that is having refractive index N2. So here this is E1 cladding. Now see, if I enter a ray inside a fiber from here, then as we know, if I say this is air and it is having refractive index N0, then if I say this angle is theta 1, then after refraction this angle will get deviated like this, and now this angle that will get to theta 2. And to have long distance propagation of this light ray, we need to have total internal reflection inside of core. So total internal reflection, that will happen only if this angle, that is greater than critical angle phi c. So if this angle is greater than critical angle, in that case there will be total internal reflection, and that is how signal will get propagated. Now see, here we insert signal from here, theta 1, and if this theta 1, that is such that this angle is critical angle phi c, in that case signal will get propagated through this optical fiber. But what if you increase this angle theta 1 beyond this phi c limit? So if that you increase more than that, in that case signal, which is what we are inserting from here, that will go out of this fiber and it will get radiated. I'll explain you that how it will happen. Now see, I am saying like, see, this is what theta 1, which is angle at which this angle is critical angle, right? So we can say this is what acceptance cone. In that case you will get it like how it is acceptance cone, right? Now see here, to understand this, if I increase signal angle greater than theta 1, so if I increase angle, which is this, if I say this theta, that is greater than theta 1, right? So in that case this angle of signal will be over here, and then after this signal that will get lost and it will get radiated. So this is what radiated signal out of this fiber. So we can say this angle theta 1, that is what angle of acceptance. So this is what maximum angle up to which signal can get propagated as per total internal reflection. And this cone, that is called as acceptance cone. This cone, that is acceptance cone. So ultimately This is a maximum angle at which signal can get propagated through optical fiber. So that is what acceptance angle. It is a maximum angle up to which signal can get propagated through optical fiber. That is acceptance angle. And cone of that acceptance angle, that is what acceptance cone. And now I'll explain how we can have a calculation of acceptance angle and numerical aperture based on this understanding. I hope that you have understood. Like, see, when you insert signal with a signal angle less than acceptance angle, in that case there will be total internal reflection and signal will propagated along the core. But if you increase signal angle greater than acceptance angle, in that case signal will get radiated out of fiber, right? So to understand derivation, I'll make again a diagram through which we can understand this. See, now I insert a signal from here. Let us say this angle is theta 1, and here air is there. Let us say it is having refractive index n0. This is core, which is having refractive index n1, and this is cladding, that is having refractive index n2. And after refraction first time over here, this angle, that is theta 2, and this angle, that is phi, and this phi and this phi, that should be greater than critical angle phi c. So that is what I have explained. And if it is greater than critical angle phi c, there will be total internal reflection and signal will get propagated like this along the optical fiber. Now let us apply some basic rules. See, if I consider this diagram and this portion, right? So in this portion, if we apply Snell's law, then we can say n0 sin theta 1 is equals to n1 sin theta 2. So n0 sin theta 1, that is equals to n1 sin theta 2. Now see, if you see this diagram over here, we have applied Snell's law. n0 sin theta 1 is equals to, see, this material is having refractive index n1 for core, n1 sin theta 2. That is what we have done. Now, if you observe this diagram, then this is making Z like this. So if this angle is phi theta 2, then this angle has to be even theta 2. If this angle, that is theta 2, then as per this Z, one can say this angle is even theta 2. And this is total 90 degree angle. Let me make this diagram little big so it will be more clear. See, this is how this diagram is there, where one can see this angle is theta 2. So this angle has to be theta 2. And if you see this angle, then that is phi. So we can say theta 2 plus phi, that is pi by 2. So from this diagram, we can say theta 2 plus phi, that is pi by 2. So theta 2 is equals to pi by 2 minus phi. So we can say from figure, theta 2, that is equals to pi by 2 minus phi. Now, if we apply this theta 2, that is equals to pi by 2 minus phi in this formula, then we can say n0 sin theta 1, that is equals to n1 sin pi by 2 minus phi. So let us further elaborate this. n0 sin theta 1, that is equals to n1 sin pi by 2 minus phi, that is cos phi. So cos phi. Now see, cos phi, that is what, as per the basic formula, sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. we can say cos phi that is equals to square root of 1 minus sin square phi. So if we elaborate this little more, then you will be getting square root of 1 minus sin square phi. Now see, here I have already told, like see this angle phi, that should be minimum critical angle. It should be more than critical angle phi c. So as I have told, this phi, that should be greater than phi c. So for critical angle, here total internal reflection that is happening in between n1 and n2 refractive index. So for critical angle, we can say sin phi c, that should be n2 divided by n1. So here if we apply this critical angle in this basic formula, then we can say n0 sin theta 1 that is equals to n1 into square root of 1 minus n2 by n1 whole square. Now let us simplify this further. So n0 sin theta 1 that is equals to, if you see n1 LCM, in that case n1 n1 will get cancelled from numerator and denominator, and this will get to square root of n1 square minus n2 square. And for air n0 is equals to 1, so we can say this will be sin theta 1 that is equals to n1 square minus n2 square. And here even we can say this is what numerical aperture, this is even numerical aperture, in short we can write this as NA. So even here we can say this is even numerical aperture NA. So this is what very basic formula of numerical aperture, where theta 1 is what acceptance angle, where theta 1 is what acceptance angle. So if you want to calculate acceptance angle, then for acceptance angle, we can say theta 1 that is sine inverse of numerical aperture, or one can say it is sine inverse of square root of n1 square minus n2 square. So acceptance angle that we have calculated and acceptance cone that I have shown earlier, see this theta 1 that is what acceptance angle. Right, and this is what acceptance cone. And if you increase incident signal with greater than the acceptance angle, in that case signal will get radiated out of fiber. That is what I have explained. Right, so based on acceptance angle we can calculate numerical aperture, and acceptance angle that we can calculate as per this basic formula, it is what sine inverse of numerical aperture or sine inverse of n1 minus n2 square. So this is how we can calculate acceptance angle and numerical aperture. Now there could be some basic formulas which is there based on index difference, right? So I'll explain this acceptance angle based on index difference. So index difference, that usually we note it down by delta n, and that is what n1 minus n2, that is what difference in between core and cladding refractive index. So if you write this basic formula of numerical aperture, so numerical aperture is what, numerical aperture that is sine theta 1 and that is even square root of n1 square minus n2 square. So we can re-elaborate this as per n1 minus n2, n1 plus n2. Now see, n1 minus n2, that is index difference, and if we consider n1 is very nearer to n2, in that case n1 plus n2, that could be written as 2n1. So here this formula, that will get changed to 2n1 into delta n. So this is one basic formula of numerical aperture based on index difference. And sometime numerical aperture, that could be even there in terms of relative refractive index. So now I'll explain relative refractive index. So relative refractive index, so that is what we noted down by delta, and that delta is n1 minus n2 divided by n1. So here from this we can say delta n1, that is equals to n1 minus n2. So if we use again same formula of numerical aperture, so numerical aperture is sin theta 1, and that is square root of n1 square minus n2 square, then that is what, n1 minus n2 into n1 plus n2. Now see, n1 minus n2, that is delta n1, and n1 plus n2, approximately that will be 2n1. So if we place that delta n1 into 2n1, then your formula will get changed to, in square root it will be n1 square, so it will come out and you will be getting it n1 into square root of 2 delta. So numerical aperture in terms of acceptance angle and relative refractive index, we can write this in this way. So ultimately, see, these are the basic formulas which is what useful to you for a calculation of examples, right? So it should be clear to you, numerical aperture is sin theta 1, where theta 1 is acceptance angle, and that is square root of n1 square minus n2 square. In terms of index difference, it will be square root of 2n1 delta n. In terms of relative refractive index, it will be n1 square root of 2 delta. That is how we can solve this type of problems based on numerical aperture and acceptance angle. I hope that you have understood this. You can write your queries here. In future, I'll explain example based on this topic, so it will be more clear to all of you. I hope that you have understood this. Please write your queries in comments. Definitely, we can have a discussion to sort out all your queries. Thank you so much for watching this video.